देशमुख, वर्किंग एज अन असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मेकॅनिकल इंजिनिअरिंग, वालचंद इन्स्टिट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नॉलॉजी, सोलापूर. इन दिस व्हिडिओ वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ वॉटर टर्बाईन अँड इफिशियन्सीज ऑफ टर्बाईन. द लर्निंग आउटकम: ॲट द एंड ऑफ धिस सेशन द लर्नर विल एबल टू क्लासिफाय डिफरंट टाईप्स ऑफ टर्बाईन्स अँड देअर इफिशियन्सीज. द कंटेंट: फर्स्ट विल सी द इंट्रोडक्शन टू टर्बाईन्स अँड पंप्स, देन द सिंपल लेआउट ऑफ हायड्रोइलेक्ट्रिक पॉवर प्लांट, देन द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ वॉटर टर्बाईन्स, अँड लास्ट द इफिशियन्सीज ऑफ टर्बाईन. नाऊ बिफोर इंट्रोडक्शन टू टर्बाईन, आय वॉन्ट यू गाईज टू टेक अ ब्रेक अँड थिंक ऑन द डिफरन्स बिटवीन द टर्बाईन्स अँड पंप्स. सो विच पॉईंट्स मेक्स द टर्बाईन्स अँड पंप्स डिफरंट? देअर यूज, देअर एनर्जी कन्वर्जन. Just note down the different points that you get in your mind. So before answering these questions, I want you guys to tell, we can convert the energy by using the fluid dynamic machines. So we can convert either the hydraulic energy to the mechanical energy or the mechanical energy to the hydraulic energy. Based on this energy conversion, we classify the turbines and pumps. So the turbines are the machines which converts the hydraulic energy to mechanical energy. Okay, the typical examples of turbines are Pelton wheel turbine, Francis turbine and Kaplan turbine. And the pumps are the machines which converts the mechanical energy to hydraulic energy. So the examples of the pumps are centrifugal pumps and reciprocating pumps. Now the turbines. The word turbine is actually derived from a Latin word turbo, which means vortex. These rotary machines extract energy from the fluid and convert it into the useful work. With the help of turbine, we can generate the electric power when combined with generators. This is the typical layout of hydroelectric power plant. We construct a dam across a river bed to increase the potential energy of water by increasing its headrace. So this water with high potential energy is transferred through the penstock and applied to the vanes of turbines with the help of nozzle. So as the stream strikes to the vanes of turbine, the turbine rotates, which is mounted on the shaft, through which we convert the mechanical energy to the electrical energy, and this electricity can be transferred with the help of cables or wires. Now we'll see the classification of water turbines. The water turbines can be classified into following four categories. The first one is according to the type of energy at inlet. The second one is according to the direction of flow of water through turbines. The third one is according to head at the inlet, and fourth one is with the specific speed. So according to the type of energy at the inlet, the turbines are classified into two subparts. That is, first one is impulse turbine, in which we apply the only kinetic energy at the inlet of turbine. And the second one is reaction turbine, in which the kinetic energy as well as pressure energy is applied at the inlet of turbine. Now, according to the direction of flow of water through turbine, we classify turbine into four subtypes: tangential flow turbine, radial flow turbine, axial flow turbine, and mixed flow turbine. So, the tangential flow turbine, in the tangential flow turbine, the water flows along the tangent of runner. The example of tangential flow turbine is Pelton wheel turbine. In figure 1, you can see with the help of nozzle, we apply the water jet to the runner, and the direction of the water is along the tangent to the runner. While in radial flow turbine, the water flows in radial direction of runner. In figure 2, you can see the water is applied at the runner of the turbine in the radial direction. Okay, and with the help of that, we generate electricity. The third type is axial flow turbine, in which water flows in axial direction of the rotation of runner. The example of axial flow turbine is Kaplan turbine. The fourth one is mixed flow turbine, in which water flows in radial direction but leaves in direction parallel to the axis of rotation of turbine. The example of mixed flow turbine is modern Francis turbine. Now I want you guys to think on the difference between the axial flow turbine and radial flow turbine. The head of low head turbine is less than 60 meter, while for medium head turbine the head changes from 60 to 250 meter, and for high head turbine the head of the turbine is above 250 meter. Then the turbines are also classified according to the specific speed of turbines, as low specific speed turbine which rotates at less than 60 rpm, the medium specific speed turbine which rotates at the speed between 60 to 400 rpm, and high specific speed turbine which rotates at the speed greater than 400 rpm. Now we'll see the efficiencies of turbine. The efficiency is nothing but the ratio of output to the input. The output is obviously the work done and the input. Okay, so the first we'll see the hydraulic efficiency of the turbine. It is defined as the ratio of power delivered to the runner to the power supplied at the inlet. So power delivered at the runner is known as the runner power, and power supplied at the inlet, we are supplying power by the water jet, so it is called as water power. So hydraulic efficiency is nothing but the ratio of runner power to the water power. Then the second efficiency is mechanical efficiency. It is defined as the power at the shaft of the turbine to the power delivered by the water to the runner. So the power at the shaft turbine is known as shaft power, and the power delivered by the water to the runner is known as runner power. So the mechanical efficiency is nothing but the ratio of shaft power to the runner power. Now the third one is volumetric efficiency. The volumetric efficiency of the turbine is defined as the volume of water actually striking to the runner to the volume of water supplied to the turbine. Now we will see the overall efficiency of the turbine. The overall efficiency of the turbine is defined as the power available at the shaft of turbine to the power supplied at the inlet of the turbine. So power available at the shaft turbine is known as shaft power, and the power supplied at inlet is known as water power. So it is the ratio of shaft power to the water power. Now we can divide and multiply this formula by the runner power. So the shaft power upon runner power multiplied by runner power to the water power. Now we know that the shaft power to the runner power, this ratio is known as mechanical efficiency, and the ratio of runner power to the water power is known as hydraulic efficiency. So the overall efficiency can also be defined as the multiplication of mechanical efficiency to hydraulic efficiency. These are the references. Thank you.